Hey everyone, welcome back to the Minecraft Academy. If you're new here, hi, I'm Honeycon, and in this playlist I give you tips on how to get better at Minecraft. The playlist is linked in the top right corner. Real quick, as always, there are better players than me, but this will be still helpful for most of you. Let's get right into it. Here are the 6 things that you need to succeed. Aim, CPS, hotbar management, hotkeys, range, and combos. Let's start with the aim. Aim is the most important thing of them all. You can have like 100 CPS, but without aim you still wouldn't be able to hit your opponent. A few weeks ago I actually played against a friend who had an auto-clicker on, and I still won. For your aim to improve, you first have to figure out your sensitivity, or mouse DPS. If you don't know what DPS is, it's basically how far your cursor moves when you move your mouse. You can customize it with most gaming mice. I recommend moving around a block and just clicking at it while you change your DPS or sensitivity. CPS. I recommend aiming for more than 8 CPS, clicks per second. I showed you 3 clicking methods in the Bedverse video, which is linked in the info card in the top right. So if you don't already have more than 8 CPS, check that out. Hotbar management and hotkeys. It's super important that you set certain locations for each item, so you don't have to look at your hotbar while fighting. Later, you'll know why this is important. When you've decided where everything is supposed to be, it's important to set hotkeys for those things. Alright, so I'm here on a practice server. It's called Mindmen. The IP will also be in the description. It's pretty cool. So this is a UHC kit, and I'm just going to show you how I organize my hotbar, and then also I'm going to show you my hotkeys. So in UHCs and all that PvP stuff, I always put blocks on the second slot, because you need blocks to block off lava and water. And also you can slow your enemies down, but we'll come to that later. And then I put lava on my 9th slot, then water here, lava there, water there. That's usually just because of the UHC kit. Like normally you don't have 2 water buckets and 2 lava buckets, but it's quite cool to set your opponent in lava and put the fire from you away, I guess. And then in this kit I have the golden apples just here, because you need all of the nine golden apples. Then the both are always on my 3rd slot, and then obviously the first slot is the sword. And yeah, I think that's basically it. If I want to play with the rod, I put the rod on this slot. You will see in a second why. It's just really good because of my hotkeys. Alright, so let's get to my hotkeys. If I go to controls, alright, so my sensitivity is on 108. That doesn't make much of a difference, but I just set it like that, I don't know. And then let me just reset here everything. So my first slot is J, which is a mouse button. And then also the second one is K, which is also on my mouse. Then I have 3rd and 4th slot on the keys, because that just works with me. On the 5th slot, that's kind of hard to reach for me, so I put that on X. Then 6 on F, 7 on V, 8 on 2, and 9 on 1. I know that those two things don't really make sense, but it's just how I did it, because I was used to playing with J and K on 1 and 2. And then obviously I have zoom on C, I think that most people have that. And also I have toggle sprint on control, I don't know where it is. Oh, there, sprint control. And then obviously sneak on shift. Then also I have tab on tab. It just makes sense, I guess.
Range. Range is an important topic, because if both players have good aim and around the same amount of CPS, it's all about using items and logic to get the first hit and start a combo. Firstly, keep in mind that you always have to aim at the thing that's closest to you. Now let's get onto the second part, running. When you're running, you have a longer range. That means that you should try to stop your opponent from running, so that you have a longer range than him. How can you do that? Here are the most common things.
Alright, so I'm gonna show you a few examples of how you can slow your opponent down. There are snowballs, rods, blocks, lava, how's it called? Flint and steel. Oh, Pika built something here. And then there's also, I don't know, anything that you can throw at your opponent works for slowing them down. And it decreases their reach, so that's pretty cool. So Pika will run at me and try to hit me. And I will just try to block him off with blocks, and that will decrease his rage, and I can just like combo him back. So when he runs
and runs at me. I can just place some blocks here. And he runs against those blocks, and that makes his reach decrease. Then also there's lava buckets, obviously. So when he runs at me, I can just put him into a lava, and now he gets damage every, I don't know, every second or something like that. And that also does damage to him. Alright, then we have the rod. I can just show that as a last example. I'm not really that good at rodding, but you just try to hit him before you start the combo. Oh, I accidentally killed him. But yeah, that's how the rod works.
Once you get the first hit, it's time for your combo. To keep a combo, you have to make sure that your enemy doesn't hit you. Two common methods are used: strafing and W tapping.
So with strafing, you just run around your opponent. Pika, just don't move for a second. I can just show it. You just run around your opponent. Maybe you could change directions and stuff. You can either gap. And but what that does is that he can't hit you because he always has to aim at you. So when we just try to do this in the fight, alright, let's go. Look at the hotkeys in the, not the hotkeys, the keystrokes in the top left corner. Yeah, okay, I didn't gap, that was dumb. Basically, I just try to run around him and try to outread him with that. Alright, GG.
After every hit, you also get slowed down. That means that your reach gets decreased. That's where W tapping comes into play. You just have to tap W after every hit, so you're running again.
Alright, so I said that I wouldn't know how to W tap, but I just figured it out. And this is how. Pika just challenged me again. So basically, you always have to sprint and spam W after every hit. So when I hit him, I press W again. Look at the top left corner. Yeah, he's probably doing it now as well. But anyways, I got the combo. Alright, let's just do this a few times again so you can see how it works. After every hit, I just basically reset my sprint. And he doesn't have range because I'm doing W tapping. And yeah, on with the video.
A quick extra about bow aim. It's really just practice. Simply put a few mobs in front of you and try to shoot them down as fast as possible. I'd also recommend getting Optifine so you can zoom in and out, which also brings me to the next video. It'll be about how you can improve your FPS. Please subscribe with the bell on so that you don't miss any future videos, and as always, have a nice day. See ya!